Hello. I've installed a few things.
Literally, plug and play.
I didn't make much of a lot. I just dug in further, deeper into the ground. And yeah, I'm leaving that over there. Free barrier, and then on top of that, it's gonna go right through the pot. That's holes. No worries. Besides, I want the pot to get drenched with water so the tree could get exactly what it needs to grow. These I got from Canadian Tire. And Valentine cherries. Cold tolerance. That's I didn't check for that. All I did was check for. Hey, look, it's about ready to bloom. I did not. That's a bonus. Then I got this. I looked at the regular ones, as you know, the classic ones, but then I looked at the autumn fern. That might be colorful. So that might. It's almost like painting. It's interesting. And everything seems to be. Working out for these tomatoes, actually. I spread them about even more. And they're taking root. They have holes at the bottom, so it has drainage. So the roots will definitely go down through them. I'm worried these pots are going to be there forever. I also put cilantro in here. So they're going to be. And like a squirrel, I forgot where I buried everything. So it took me a while to figure out what. And from Canadian Tire, also got that one. Where did I put it? See, like a squirrel. Check it out. All the birdies are. Look at that. They're not as afraid of me anymore. And I don't want any harm for them, so I want them to live happily just like everybody else. I know it's corny, whatever, but Jesus, enough pain in this world. It's easy to. And then, by the by, that was a cabbage. Yeah, that was the cabbage. And then I put it out, and here it started growing, and looks like it's actually doing really well. It's taking root. In other words, look, the top is, yeah, it's blooming. Took some of the carrots and put them in here. Just waiting for them to, you know, sprout. That's what dwarf dill. Got this Canadian Tire for $2. Rescue plant. Awesome idea. Awesome. Yeah, it's easy fix. Not fix, but easy grow. This little Italian cilantro, absolutely awesome. Doing really well. It's getting cat. Yeah, it's digging in really deeply. So I'm glad about that because they're perennials. I want them to be coming out blooming strong. Oh. Yeah. I need that one there. And to let them out, and put some snow peas in there or peas. Because there's a lot of them that I forgot where I put, so I had to think about it. Oregano, of course. You can't. Maybe it's upside down. Whatever. It's there. Look at the potatoes. How rich they are. That's really awesome. And they were just about to go, and instead I put them all in for growing. And like I said, even the beans are growing also. Check that out. Beautiful leaves. Rich greens. Wow. Actually, I didn't think they were all that big. Man. been a while since I've grown stuff. Then onions, I literally actually take off the snap off. Just gobble them up. And then, of course, black currants. And black currants, and I just put these guys in as well. Lavender, let them grow as much as I can. Probably gonna end up getting rid of those, but these over here, they smell really nice. Don't know what the benefits are, but should I look it up and find something? All I know is it's a fantastic smell. Then, of course, this is the other one I installed. Ba-ba-ba-ba. It comes with three kinds of fruit. Once it blooms, oh, it'd be really nice and interesting. Yeah. She's a beautiful, beautiful tree. But I looked at the bark, never really noticed how gorgeous it was. Bark, nice tree. Where's the other one? Yeah, that was the cherry tree. It has similar bark. Look. It's almost like a, how to describe it? Definitely. I love the texture. It's gorgeous. Cherry tree, huh? Apparently you could make some good lumber out of it, I don't know. But I got it for lease. Lease at all. Since this guy likes getting watered, this guy's gonna grow nice and strong pretty fast. Then this one has to have water always. I'm glad about that that autumn cold tolerance. Oh. But I'm still going to enclose this area for entirely growing purposes, like this. Grow up. Sorry, this is my grow up. Yeah, I'm not worried about the beans. If they sprout, they sprout, because I also have other, you might see the bars or prints, almost like footprints. Yeah, that's where I put the different herbs. Mm-hmm. So beans will come out, no worries, tomorrow. There's a song about that. Ooh, there goes the heart. Yeah, and the cucumbers. Yeah. These, when I found out that these were perennial, I got giddy happy. Totally giddy happy. Perennials, I usually put some seeds in there as well, right in this area. And squash is going to be, that's why I just remember squash is going to be out there. And then on top of that, over there, and put up a whole bunch of, I didn't put the labels, but herbs, perennial herbs. So there's going to be tarragon and some other ones as well. Maybe oregano, thyme, for sure. Well, it's going to be busy up there. 10 minutes in. So, dang. Thank you, Mom. By the way, Mom paid for these. And, yeah, so I'm going to have to keep an eye on the plum. Because, yeah, the lily over there, I want to suffocate in this bit of beauty. This little baby. But this one's doing fine and gorgeous and healthy. Yeah, so because of that, the extras, I could have made this little cave. I'm gonna put a little shelf on top, maybe. I don't know. Just for the giggles. Oops, oops, that thing is. That way the compost will stay in there. So I'll just wait for some more lumber material from the lilac. And happy, happy, joy, joy. This will be built up even more. Parsley is absolutely gorgeous. Healthy. Yeah, strawberries. I'm hoping. We'll see. There's some more beans, magical beans. And I can't wait to see what the colors are. Honestly, cannot wait to see what the colors are. I'm just hoping this one grows stronger and faster. Good thing about ferns, they grow, they're hardy. Yeah, this one's from Canadian Tire. Also, I wouldn't know. Delicious fruits. And of course. Wow. Yeah. I don't care if the neighbor gets some, because I'm all kind of hoping that it spreads. Its branches right over. It needs as much sun as possible, so that way, hey, they get the cherries, I get cherries too. And they get maximum, just gets maximum sun exposure. Happy, happy, joy, joy for everyone. And the plum over here, it's a little secluded. I need the sun. This one's also cold tolerance. Not too bad. Yeah, perfect. Well, except for the minus 37. We've had a minus 37 here before. That's exactly why I need the greenhouse. Like I said, we've had minus 37 here before. And minus 40. Even with the wind chill, that goes up even. Ouch. Holy, it feels like everything is a bullet. Anyways. Yeah. Growing really healthy. Awesome. Just kept watering it. As soon as I get more money, put more stuff in here for